All right, so I've been flooded with requests recently to do a breakdown of the incident that happened on Boat Therapy this past Monday evening. What we saw was really just a horrible demonstration of how to net a fish by Brian Kittock. And I'm hoping that if we go through a few things of what happened during this incident, you know, what went wrong and what Brian could have done better in the future with some demonstrations of some other netters that we have examples of, hopefully we can all learn something and come away with better netting skills by the end of this video. All right, so setting the stage here, what we have is Andrew Folgers, an experienced king hunter. He's got a nice king on the line here. He's actually champion of the Lac and Lax fishing tournament from 2014, I want to say. And he's been fighting this king for about 20 minutes now. And before we roll the tape, let's take a look at what actually happened about 10 minutes prior to the clip we're on. So this is about 10 minutes prior to the frame we were just looking at, and what we could see on the screen is that there's a serious tangle in the line. It appears that the downrigger that Andrew's been fighting the fish on is actually tangled with one of the dipsies, as well as I think one of the long lines that have been out. And we have Captain Paul and eventually myself going in performing surgery on these lines in order to untangle them. And you know, it's really this clip that sets the stage for what's later to come in the fight of this fish. I mean, just the buildup here and just the teamwork that's being put in from everybody in the boat in order to help Andrew get this fish in the boat. And then Brian's fatal flaw that we're about to see shortly. It really just goes to show that a chain or a team is really only as strong as its weakest link.
Nice! I can't believe we untangled that in like 30 seconds.
So at this point, we're ready to fast forward to the point where the fish is actually approaching the back of the boat. And there's a couple things we want to look at here. All right, so what we have here is really the first mistake that was made that led to the poor chain of events that we saw on Monday evening. We have Captain Paul on the left holding the net, and he's verbally offering Brian Kittock to see if he wants to net the fish at the back of the boat. And what you notice is Brian, he's physically kind of backing off the net. He's got his hands in the air. He's putting himself in kind of a vulnerable position. And he's obviously physically and mentally nervous about this whole situation. He's made claims before that he's a great netter. But deep down, maybe subconsciously, he's got doubts about his abilities. And this should have been the first telltale sign from Captain Paul that, you know, maybe he shouldn't hand Brian the net in this situation. Now, I also think it's worth taking a look at this clip from a little earlier in the evening. This is Brian confidently expressing that he's a good netter. And, you know, I don't know if he maybe felt a little bit more confident in this situation since the fish being pulled in was merely like a 12-inch coho that, you know, almost was the size of a large perch or what. But it's worth just noting this for what you're about to see later in the video.
Don't make a mistake, Brian. It's all gonna be documented. I could do slow-mo on this thing. Documented. I could do slow-mo on this thing.
Great, so now that that's been noted, let's go ahead and jump back to present time.
Brian, come on, Brian, that's you, baby. Yeah, let's go.
All right, so what we heard right there was a lot of banter from the guys in the boat, and that's most likely why Brian ended up taking this net was just the pure pressure. And it's really shocking in a lot of ways because it appears that Brian hasn't learned anything about peer pressure from his college days. And what I want you to listen for in this next short clip is Captain Paul vocalizing some advice to Brian about holding the bottom of the net as he's about to net the fish. And I'll actually play it back for you a couple times just so it's nice and clear. All right, so now that that's been noted, we can see that Andrew is pulling up this king towards the back of the boat. And I'd like to take a moment to take a look at how Brian's preparing to net this fish. So what we see here, and remember that this is merely 10 seconds after Captain Paul gave his advice, that Brian has his left hand very high up on the pole of the net. It's actually nowhere near the actual netting, completely disregarding the advice that Captain Paul gave. We're going to see really soon how this, combined with some of his other technique flaws, comes back to bite him. So we're now at the point of approach where the fish is coming up to the back of the boat. And we need to go ahead and stop the clip right about here. All right, so this is really where things get ugly. So what we see here is Brian is trying to make a stab at netting this fish. And the yellow little foot right there is actually representing Brian's left chicken leg that really should be on the other side of the barrier on the back of the boat in order to give himself some more leverage when netting this fish. We could see the circle of his left hand. As we mentioned earlier, he made no corrections to his placement of his left hand, and at no point did it actually touch the netting. It really should have been where that arrow is pointing, all the way down at the netting, and then released right before this clip. So at this point right here, we can see that Brian has actually managed to get the hook that was in the fish's mouth now stuck in the net, and the fish is not in the net. This is really just a nightmare situation for any professional netter, and they'd really never let this happen to themselves. But because of Brian's technique, we now find ourselves in this situation. And we should take a look back and see what Captain Paul actually did back in 2020 when he was in a similar situation. He was able to recover from this mistake. So here is said clip, and I mean, first and foremost, let's take a moment to appreciate Captain Paul's impeccable form for netting here. I mean, bonus points for having the life preserver on a calm day. But we could see that his eyes are focused forward, looking at the fish, watching its approach. In the green, we could see that his left hand has actually got the netting within it. That's been the call of the question throughout this whole video, the fact that why did Brian not have his hand on the netting? We can see a Captain Paul has that done. And then also in the red, we see that his legs are properly positioned where he's basically straddling the back end of the boat. And this is going to allow him to get more leverage on the fish when he's netting it. So now that we've taken a look at Paul's form, let's go ahead and see how he handles the situation he's about to encounter. So Lieutenant Dan is actually bringing this fish between the center and left rigger. And right here, we see that Paul's actually encountering a very similar situation to what Brian had in the past clip. The center rigger is dangerously close to the fish that's coming in, but we see that Paul doesn't make any kind of premature jabs at the fish. Also note in this frame that literally the frame right before this one, Paul just released the netting from his left hand. That's what we've been preaching this whole video, and he executed it perfectly in this clip. So now what we're going to see right here is a really unfortunate situation. We can see that the fish actually kicks up right before he's going into the net. No fault of Paul's own. And now he finds himself in literally the exact same situation as Brian, where the hook is caught in the net and the fish is dangling from that hook. But we see right here something that you very rarely see in practice, and it's even more rare to catch it on video, is a 180 flip of the net executed by Paul right here. He flips the net and scoops up the fish to get it into the boat. Now, certainly this is a maneuver that took Paul years of experience to develop, and we couldn't expect Brian to perform such a maneuver. But at the same time, you'd really hope to see Brian not find himself in this situation in the first place. So we're just going to go ahead and roll the clip and let the audio speak for itself.
Get it! Oh! No!
All right, when I was going back into editing, I couldn't help but notice Brian's complete lack of situational awareness right here. I mean, a good netter, if they lost a fish at the back of the boat, first reaction is to jump in and grab that thing if it's floating to the top. But Brian, I mean, you can see here, he's got his shoulders are slugged back. He's itching his nose or something, you know, trying to comfort himself. I don't know. I'm not a psychologist, but just really just a complete, like I said, lack of regard for the situation. And he's not even thinking about making an attempt to try to scoop the fish or grab the fish, which is something you just hate to see out of a netter. Upon review, we also saw that Andrew was holding in tears at this point. Brian's biting his lip and just really overall sad and unfortunate situation.
I'm handling the dip net next time.
We're not eating tonight. Here's another angle of the incident.
Reel down.
Walk back.
Man, that is just tough to watch. Let's take a closer look at some of the crew members' reactions.
Oh! No!
What is that, John?
No.
Oh my god.
Now, at the end of the first angle, we saw Dan Diedrichs proclaiming that he was going to take the next one. We love that energy on Team Therapy, and here's an angle of him doing just that. Just a great job by Dan overall, and we love the energy he's bringing here, pointing out Brian, who's watching on from the front of the boat, calling him out, saying that's how it's done. We always love a little bit of banter here on Team Therapy. But notice that Dan still has only – he only has one hand on the net, and the net is still suspended over the water. Not ideal, not the best form here. Dan definitely needs to work on being able to maintain his focus until the fish is secured in the boat. But let's take a look at another angle. So here we see Dan's properly holding the netting. Just a monster that Mr. Folgers has in the line right here. Nets it perfectly, points out Brian, celebrates a little bit. Of course, if this was a bigger fish, definitely would want to have two hands on the net. But overall, great execution here by Dan Diedrichs. Jumping forward, we'd love to see that Dan, before turning off the camera, properly secures the net back in its housing on the side of the boat. We had an incident with Brian, actually, later this evening of him actually grabbing the net as kind of a handlebar when he's coming down onto the boat, nearly snapping the handle of the net. It's getting to a point where we really cannot even let Brian Kiddock touch the net soon, maybe even not come on the boat. Really just shocking what we've seen out of him this weekend, given that he's a two-time champion in the Lac des Lacs tournament. Now we have one more bonus clip here that a user actually sent in of Dan Diedrichs landing another fish in the net. Really just a hot weekend on the water for Dan.
Wait till he's close, Dan.
No, wait, keep reeling.
Yes!
Woo!
Hope you got that on camera. Oh, it's on camera, baby. Nice fish. Nice job. Give me some.
Now, if you thought that the whole Brian losing and Dan winning saga was over on the boat, think again, because our camera crew got special access into the poker game that occurred at the house after the boat on Monday night. And believe it or not, Dan got a hand dealt to him where he had four aces, triggering a payout from $20 from everybody around the table. And meanwhile, to finish off the night, Brian put up a $50 bet when he was dealer, triggering a loss after he got a jack high gow, having to pay out between $20 and $50 to everybody at the table.
You got there, Dan.
What a dick.
I paid.
You suck.
But Brian's woes didn't stop there. Out on the course, we got reports that apparently Brian's drives were not even making it up to the ladies' tees on a lot of the holes. And as a result, his foursome insisted that, you know, he had to wear the pink skirt for the day, take off his shirt, and really take on the role that matched the way he was playing.
Oh, it didn't go anywhere.
Now, our team wanted to dig deeper into why Brian was having such a bad weekend. So we decided to use cutting-edge GoPro technology that you put on an individual's forehead, and it shows the point of view perspective from that individual in the way that they're seeing it. So for example, if it was put on my grandpa's head, you see black blotchy spots all over the screen because he's partially blind. In Brian's case, we were suspecting that he was highly intoxicated and inebriated throughout this trip while golfing, fishing, playing cards, and things of that nature. So without Brian knowing about this technology, we put the camera on his head to see his perspective while we were out on the water playing cards.
Oh, hi, Jeff.
All right. Good to go. Let's get that out there.
I'll deal it.
All right, this bet is nullified until we get through our deals.
Got a small head there, don't you?
Zombies drink.
No problem.
You're right. It's not.
Somebody else sings the song.
$20 max bet. Right.
This is nullified.
$4 you said?
Get through our
$20 deal. Max
agree?
Bet.
This no. doesn't count because I'm already betting $20.
I'm going
so
why would
you bet on this? This
we
is for
have,
other people.
We have to bet on that.
Well, I'll take my money.
Anybody can beat themselves a fine guy, so I'll bring
it. It sat there for like 10 hands.
I know. Once we through our deals, it will be back on.
Ryan's almost cross-eyed.
I know. I feel Asian.
Well, good start.
Wow. That was easy.
All right, workable.
Nice hand.
Wow, that's a really good hand. You didn't have a straight flush, though, with all those hearts and the extra one.
I know.
Don't get it.
And the extra
that
one.
That sucks.
Yeah. He's ready to lose some money.
Oh, I got you.
Oh, nice. There we go.
Damn it.
Sweet. I could have split him in one.
Woo!
Push.
Ric Flair.
Push.
Nice.
Push.
I beat you, right?
I got a push, Brain.
All right. Yeah, you did not lose.
Yep. I only lost $5.
I don't kick again.
All right.
Can I have the cards, please?
Get on.
Man, what would we do without modern-day technology? And who knew that Brian could get so hammered off just a few seltzers? I think everyone, especially Brian, is looking forward to being back in Canada next year. But let's take a look at how we made the most out of South Haven with the border being closed. All right, one under through four. Three of us went in the sand.
Yes! Yes! Woo! Let's go! Let's go! Yeah, you like that?
Or in between.
Ladies and gentlemen,
nice
we
shot.
Got him.
Nice shot. That's a key player.
Not in a million years. It's your way to get out without paying everybody $5 in a shit hand.
No.
What are you playing? Like,
what are you playing face off then?
Either way, that really didn't count.
Point counterpoint.
Already rolling.
This is good.
Mr. Vegas, you're shuffling.
Explain your technique.
You ever get any calls from Vegas? They want a dealer?
Pull some out, pull out the middle. Get on.
That's a cut.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this. That looks good.
Oh.
Start.
What the hell?
Oh!
Yeah, that's better than I do.
Yeah, definitely better than
you. Gee, what about Mr. Buzzkill over there, huh? What do you mean I'm just going to jump off?
Let her take out mine.
Listen to Garrett.
Essential shot out of the sand here with Dan. Good practice swing.
Time camera.
It's in a hole!
Don't use a net this time if it's low.
Yeah!
Woo!
Fish on!
Beautiful.
I'm not touching it.
That's a coho.
It hurts. Let's try not to get that totally tangled.
Yeah, that hook's not as bad as the other one.
The other one was a rainbow. That's a coho. That's got more of a forked tail. That's the one.
Beautiful fish.
Woo! We got her on that.
I'm just trying to get you in the video as little as possible so I have less blurring to do after.
We can get away. Reel that in a little there.
Two for two.
Hey, hold it up in front of Chris.
That was on the one that
hold it up in front of him. Hey!